Hello and welcome to Markaz videocast. In this episode, let's take a look at the healthcare report. The GCC countries have over the last decade transformed themselves to a state that places them on par with developing and sometimes even developed countries in terms of healthcare indicators such as life expectancy, mortality, fertility rates, etc. The journey is largely attributable to the government's commitment to the improvement of both public health and the healthcare sector. What are the factors that encourage investment in the healthcare sector of a country? The gross domestic product, inflationary expectations, the competitive environment, health policy, government willingness to boost the sector, and taxation policy. The GCC scores an A+ on most of these counts. GDP per capita in the GCC has grown at a CAGR of 6% between 2000 and 2009. Even the highest adolescent fertility rate in the GCC of 24.7 in the UAE happens to be lower than that of UK, US, Egypt and India as of 2010. While Saudi had the highest crude birth rate at 21.6, Qatar had the lowest at 12.7. The crude death rate has been on the decline too, with the UAE registering a maximum decline of 30% over the 10-year period. Qatar has the highest life expectancy at 78 years, comparable to the United States and the United Kingdom. Over the 10-year period, health expenditure per capita has grown at a CAGR of 7.9% for the GCC nations as a whole. Public health expenditures in the GCC countries ranges between 63 and 80% of total health expenditure. The GCC governments would like to reduce their contribution to the healthcare sector over time, given that the availability of petrodollars cannot be sustained forever. Country-level healthcare expenditure forecasts are made using a top-down approach with a breakup of public and private health expenditure. Markaz forecasts total health expenditure in GCC to be $79 billion in 2015, with public health expenditure amounting to 64% of the aggregate. The report highlights areas that offer investment possibilities and challenges faced by the healthcare sector. Thank you.